So hello everyone.
Hello.
Welcome to the new day and new vlog. Today we have with us our beloved Muntasir, and we thought that today we'll discuss about our psychology final presentation. Correct. So if we start with this.
So that was like the first confusion part. What is psychology presentation?
Correct.
So initially for the beginning class, we had in our mind, the professor said that there will be a presentation at the end of the lecture,
yeah,
and we have to present our term paper. So we thought of that, but later the presentation class was cancelled.
Correct.
We didn't have any day, and we had some deadline to submit the term paper online.
Yeah.
So we were confused that whether we have to submit the presentation or not. So
yeah,
we are not sure. And the professor then notified us via OLAT that we have to submit our presentation.
Yeah.
We have to record a presentation.
Correct.
So I think that's the first time we have done it.
Yeah. And the thing is, like, you can also watch the video about our psychology final term paper as well, where we had to make our term paper ready, because we thought that we had to upload that in, you know, OLAT, and OLAT. We'll receive the review for our draft term paper. That's yes, a different story. You can watch that video for in detailed description. And that's why we thought that we'll also discuss about our psychology final presentation experience.
Correct.
So,
and if haven't watched that term paper video, then pause this video, go there, yeah, watch that.
Yeah, we have discussed about different tasks and reports, so you can get an idea about these assignments.
Correct.
So now the thing is, we earlier thought that we'll receive the review, then we'll, yes, make the final term paper.
Correct.
Then we'll make the presentation based on,
so
that.
So part by part.
Part by part. But suddenly, I think we had to submit both of the things.
Both of the things,
yeah.
We didn't get the review for the draft paper.
Yeah.
So we had to prepare the term paper final version.
Yeah.
We have actually done it quite well, I would say.
Yeah.
We didn't have much to change.
Yeah.
But we had to prepare for the presentation. And it was a new thing for us that we have to record our presentation, a,
yeah,
6-minute video,
yeah,
of us presenting the topic,
yeah,
and submit it in OLAT.
Correct. And the thing is, we also received, I think later on, the documents were also uploaded in OLAT. Regarding the instructions.
Correct.
So it was like we had one good PDF, one bad PDF.
That's true. That's true. So there was some example PDF on OLAT,
yeah,
where you can see, okay, this is how a good presentation should look like.
Yeah.
This is how a bad presentation should look like.
Correct.
Well, we can say a bit like the common things. There should be some image, some, yeah, theories, and there should not be just long lines of,
yeah,
theories,
yeah,
like any presentation it should be.
Yeah.
We have also discussed these concerns in our project and seminar presentation discussion.
Yeah.
We have mentioned that these things you should keep in mind while doing any presentation.
Yeah.
Watch that video as well.
Yeah. So you can go to RPTU Castellotin playlist and watch different vlogs. Now the thing is, we had these sample PDFs.
Correct.
So, and we got an idea that, okay, we can make our presentation maybe 14 slides or 15 slides.
Correct.
And the thing is, it should be based on our reviews, but we did not have
whatever term paper we had, we have
draft term paper,
yeah, we have to prepare the presentation for that,
yeah, based on that. So and based on the example PDFs, I think there was one bad PDF. It was named as bad PDF, and in that, I think there was theory written.
Yeah, there's too much theory.
Yeah.
And one slide, there's like 5-6 lines of long lines,
yeah,
and theory.
Yeah. So when we referred those, and when we compared those, then we got an idea, okay, we should maybe either include bullet points, right? Or maybe we should not add that much theory.
That much theory, or if it's possible, add some pictures. That's always like very good,
yeah,
idea.
Yeah. And in that, I think there were graphs as well,
that's
diagrams
true,
as well, that were attached to the to that PPT. So we thought that, okay, maybe what we can do is we can make according to ourselves, because we do not have any reviews. What we can do is we can review within ourselves.
Correct.
So we can prepare that, considering that, okay, we'll make only 10 or 11 slides.
Yeah.
Because I think, like he mentioned, for seminar and project, this was the thing that you don't include much information, because you have to present. Also, before that, the thing is, now we have to record, but earlier it was like we have to present in class. So we thought that, okay, we'll add some one or two points or text, and then we can explain later in class. But there was no class later on. So we had to manage it online.
That's right. I believe you also shared some information like where can we make the presentation.
Yeah.
Some online tool that maybe you can share in,
yeah,
the comment box,
yeah,
or
yeah,
description box. So yeah, there was some link where I think you have generated your presentation.
Yeah. So this was the first time, because for us to make a presentation and make a recording out of it. So what I did was, I somehow found that there is OBS studio, OBS tool that one can use. I'll put that video link in description. I referred that video where he explained how to use this tool to record the presentation, because it's like we have to, in class we have the projector, so we can just, you know, switch to the next presentation and can explain. But now we have to do that in a video. So what we did was, or what I did was, that we first made the presentation before recording. I think we reviewed as well.
That's true.
We reviewed the presentation slides, that okay, it looks like there is a heading, there is a subheading. Also, one more thing, one can use Canvas as well,
yeah,
to refer to the templates.
You have used Canvas to do that.
Yeah.
But for me, I did it using PowerPoint only.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So you can do according to yourself. But like I use Canvas.
Whatever you prefer, actually.
Yeah. And in that Canvas, we had some templates, like where you can add titles.
Nice templates, I would say. Your PDF looks really good.
Yeah, thanks, bro. So. But it's like headings, subheadings, then points.
Yes.
And one point was, like we had in our draft term paper, which is also our final term paper with some modifications like spelling errors or correcting them out. What we did was, we took this step that first we'll add introduction. Then we'll add maybe for each research paper one slide.
One slide,
yeah.
Something like
so,
that. And then,
maybe references one slide.
References.
Yeah.
And before that, there is a conclusion as well.
Yeah, yeah.
So,
it would somehow fit to 10 slides or 11 slides.
Yes.
And you can add a last thank you slide as well. So the thing is, I used the OBS tool. And in that, we recorded our presentation, like I spoke, like what is written in that presentation, because it has a timer as well.
Yes.
And the recording gets saved in the laptop as well. So you can just see that is your sound correct or not, or for how much part you want your face to be there. Why I'm mentioning it is that because when I recorded the presentation around 6 minutes and I sent to Muntasir, then Muntasir reviewed it. And what was your review, Muntasir?
So my review was since he recorded it and in a separate video.
Yeah.
And one more thing is, you may have noticed that he is saying we and I. So that's another reason is I didn't use the OBS software.
Yeah.
But for his video, it was like there was slide and there was his video as well.
Mm.
But the problem was there was some his face was covering some of the slides point or the bullet points, I would say.
Yeah. So because it's like there is a start button. So suppose you can adjust your size, like till what point you want your face to be there, right? So in what area. And what happens is that we were recording it. I was recording it. He recorded in PowerPoint, right?
Yeah.
So I was recording it and I did not realize that some of the points were getting covered.
Covered,
the bullet points or the heading.
Correct.
And it was on that area. So he told me that.
So when we reviewed, we saw, okay, this is how it is covering. So then what I think you did was changing the slide a little bit, change the orientation, changing the bullet points a little bit. So there is a space to show your video.
Yeah.
And
my face as well.
Yeah,
and
so
reduce that size of the frame
as well. And then it was good.
Yeah.
And for me, I did it in Microsoft PowerPoint. I had the paid version, and there you have a record button.
That was interesting.
Yeah, there is a record and transcribe button as well. So for that record button, it automatically adjusts your slide and your face out of that slide.
Yeah.
So I didn't have this problem, and I can see the timer as well.
Yeah.
So it was quite good. I had to record 2-3 times just to make it on time.
Yeah.
Because sometimes I'm getting too fast or getting too slow.
Yeah.
But yeah, it was good.
And the thing is, one thing that he also mentioned was that I should hide the taskbar. You remember?
Correct.
Because for me, it was not the option that during slideshow I can record it or for the initial time. So he said that just
hide the
taskbar
so
and
like
then
you for watching full screen.
And then with the slideshow, you can start recording yourself and adjust the frame size so that you don't cover any text. And it looks good. And then I think we recorded again. One more point that he mentioned after I sent in the presentation or the recording was that when I mentioned the references, that should be in alphabetical order.
Alphabetical order,
So that was also one of the points that I got to know from him. So we reviewed within ourselves.
Correct.
And I think we somehow managed to
manage the presentation within a day, I would say.
And and how you prepared your slide, like what were you thinking?
The same thing, like initially I had same introduction and thesis paper and the conclusion as well. But I also thought when I am recording, I was thinking the professor and the audience is in front of me. And then I am explaining them the topics.
Yeah.
So it's not like just I am talking. I am trying to explain what is my topic.
Is,
like if anyone is watching it, he can understand it. So that was my motivation.
And one thing I realized realized was that since we had supposed 10 or 11 slides, so it's maybe less than a minute for a slide. That's you have true. To speak. So sometimes, you know, you have to adjust the time.
Adjust the time.
Yeah. So
for some slides, I went faster. For some slides, okay, I can talk a little bit about this.
Yeah. But yeah, it was a new experience because that was the first time I used the OBS Studio, you know, to record a presentation. But I think I loved it because then you get to know thing like how to use that tool, how you can record the presentation in future, because we were not prepared for that. We thought that we would be presenting in the class. Okay. But anyways, this is also a new experience. And the thing is, one more modification which was there, we had to upload our slide as well as the recording in
the
OLED
final version as
in OLED. But I think it was already submitted. It was showing that it's
The professor said the deadline is changed,
but it was not visible in OLED.
On OLED.
Yeah.
So at the end, what we did was we mailed our result, our term paper and presentation to the professor directly.
Yeah. So this was also a new thing. Like we. Like I think we generated a link, we made a link, right?
That's
for the video, because we can't attach I think that much big file in mail. So we made a link, then
made a link and then uploaded it and then shared the link. We also tried with ourselves that the link is able to open or not.
So before mailing to the professor, we tried, you know, making PPT within ourselves, recording within ourselves, like review it and how we have to send the mail, because I think it's about our final presentation and final term paper. So although till now we have not received
the result.
Yeah.
We are hoping to get good marks, but still it's on the process.
Yeah.
We haven't got it. It's a little bit unusual, I would say, but we're still waiting for
Because the next semester has already started. Yes. You must have seen that we are attending class. We are going into the ML class. Today also was our ML class before this video. So, but let's see when we'll get the result. Yes. Maybe then we'll update you. But I think this is all about our experience. Any more point that you want to
think we have covered almost everything.
Yeah, so just use OBS tool, or if you have the paid version, you can use the
PowerPoint.
And maybe if you have someone, then you can ask someone to review, you know, to get another perspective, so that if there are any mistakes, then they can be highlighted. Otherwise, you can review within yourselves. So that's it for our psychology final presentation. And rest, you know, thank you, Muntasir, first of all, for being part of this video after such a good time. And thank you for sharing your insights as well. Rest, you know, like, comment, share, subscribe. It doesn't take much time. Bye bye. Ciao ciao. Namaste.
Assalamualaikum.
Chalo. See you in new day, new vlog.